Hello students, let us discuss about test planning in today's lecture. Moving ahead, when we talk about test planning, there are different aspects that are a part of it. The first aspect which deals with understanding which are the different kinds of questions or which are the different kinds of tests we can administer to the students. So in order to understand the different types of tests and the different types of items, it is important for us to know each of these types and see how we can make the best use of it in the question paper. So the first one is essay test. You must be very familiar with this term essay because it is referred to as any written test that requires an examinee to write a sentence, a paragraph or a longer passage that demands a subjective judgment about its quality and completeness when it is good. We know when we write our essay test, we are supposed to write a lot of things, okay, maybe a paragraph, sometimes a sentence or a passage, okay, and we will be judged based on what quality of material that we produced and whether it is complete, whether it is in sequence or not, when it will be scored by the teacher. There are certain characteristics to that. It is most familiar and widely used type of test because it helps the teacher to frame those questions very easily, and it also helps the teacher in assessing those evaluation sheets or those question papers, answer papers easily. Moving ahead, the length of the required response may vary from one sentence to a lengthy composition. So when we have heard about essay test, we always have understood about essay is maybe a paragraph, a page or a two length. Or a very lengthy answer. But technically, the length of the required response, it can vary from a sentence to a lengthy composition because the understanding of essay is based on the basis of the expression of it, the subjectivity which is associated with the answer and not the length of it. And it should be something that demands a subjective judgment. As we have just seen, that subjectivity is something which is sometimes can be a bit difficult to judge, but also easier at times because when we try and correct a question, an answer paper with subjective judgment or a subjective answer, all answers in one way or the other are correct. You cannot penalize a student for not answering in a particular way. So that's why essay questions or essay answers are considered to be most accepted. It requires a student to plan his or her own answers, isn't it? So each one, as I just said, need to prepare or write the answers in the way they are comfortable with. And pupils have linguistic skills are at an advantage. So those who are really good at writing, expressing their point of view, such kind of tests are of really a good help to those, and they can really put forward their points in a very good language. And questions are relatively few but broad. When we have, when we frame questions which are essay type, they are relatively few because a lot has to be written for each question, so we need to keep the number less. But the questions are a bit broad, so it takes that much amount of time in order to write and do justice to that given question. So these are some of the characteristics of essay type of question, which we all of us mostly know. But one thing that I want you all to register in your mind is that when we talk about essay, it's not about one page or two page, but it is about the judgment, that is subjective judgment. If an answer can be judged subjectively, it is considered to be an essay test. Now there are distinctive features which are associated to this particular test. First thing is that no single answer can be considered correct. As I've already said, since it is subjective, there is no single answer that is correct. The examinee is permitted freedom of response, so the examinee can write the response the way they want. And the answers may vary in degree of quality and of correctness. So the quality can vary, the correctness of the answers can also vary. It needs comprehensive explanation, so the explanation should be such that it should convey the understanding of the question by the examinee to the person who is evaluating those answer papers. Answer expects the learner to organize his ideas. So as we just discussed, that writing an essay answer is a bit easier, but it is not as easy as it looks because for someone who doesn't know to express him or her or for a person who doesn't know how to organize his ideas in a short time, where he or she even has to write a lot, it becomes a bit difficult. So it is important for one to understand how to organize the ideas. So there are two major types of responses that we can expect when it comes to essay type of question. The first one is extended response, which can be a discussion form, and the second one is restricted response, which can be a short answer as well. Now, when we discuss extended response, there is no restriction which is placed on the students, as in there is no word limit that is given to them. This permits its ability to recall factual knowledge that they already have about a concept on which the question is asked, evaluate his or her factual knowledge, organize his or her ideas based on how he or she would want to express, present his or her ideas in a logical, coherent fashion. For example, describing the defects of present-day examination system. Here, if you notice, there are no word limit. There is no word limit mentioned. There is no specific instruction that is being placed, that is right in two paragraphs or 200 words or 250 words or five characteristics. Such things are not mentioned in the question. So it becomes an extended response wherein there is no restriction that is placed, which is a kind of a discussion type of a question. Now, the second type, that is restricted response. It is more limited in the form and scope of his answer. Since it is restricted, as the name suggests, it is more limited because the context of the answer is already specified. For example, explain in not more than 100 words the chemical changes that take place in our day-to-day life. So here the limit is already mentioned to them in the question, so they are not supposed to exceed the limit. So that's why it is called a restricted response. So when we talk about an essay type of a question, you can think of any two types. First one is extended type of response or restricted. Extended talks about something which doesn't have any restriction in terms of words. Second one is restricted response, wherein the restriction is mentioned in the question itself and the students are not supposed to exceed that. Now, what are the advantages of essay type of a question? Now, it is relatively easier to prepare and administer, as I already discussed in the beginning. It is the only means to access examinee's ability to organize and present the matter. So, ability of organizing the content can be only understood when we ask an essay type of a question. So, we cannot say that essay type of questions are easier in a way, because even if you frame a question very intelligently, the students would need to organize their ideas in a certain way to convey what they want. And it can be successfully employed. Logical thinking and critical reasoning can be best developed with that, because if a question is asked the right way, it can help the student think logically and also reason out. And that reasoning will be something very critical, because it would require the student to learn and understand the concept well in order to express that in a concise manner. It induces good study habits, because a student needs to learn a lot. Eliminates guessing, because there is no guesswork involved. You can only answer this question when you are really aware of the concept and can explain that in a very compressed or maybe concise manner. It's more economical, because it helps the teacher to frame questions in a very short span of time, and doesn't take much time of the teacher, because other types of questions which we will discuss would take a bit of more time, because you need to understand kind of area you are choosing for those kind of questions and options that you would give. So essay type of questions are much easier in that sense. So that's why they are called more economical. So these were some of the advantages. Now, moving ahead, let us see some of the disadvantages as well. It possesses relatively low validity and reliability. When we talk about validity, it is about whether the students really know what they are writing, or they are just reading around the bush, so that you cannot really guess when you ask a question, which is an essay type of a question. Reliability, in a manner that consistency, because whenever an essay type of a question is asked, you cannot expect the same answer, even not only from different students, but sometimes from the same person, because a person would express himself or herself in different ways, and the same question is asked at different times. So that's why the question of reliability and validity being questioned arises here. Now, why it is so? Because of the limited content sampling. Because the content that they have to select for writing the answer is limited. So which part of the content they would select while expressing their point of view about the question will be different every time. Subjectivity of scoring. Again, when you score a mark, an answer sheet of an essay type of an answer, subjectivity is something which is one of the negatives of it, because you cannot compare the answers of the students, because each answer will be expressed in a different way. There will be subjectivity in the scoring system. It is affected by several extraneous factors like the spelling, good handwriting, grammar, neatness. If the students are good at all those four factors like the spelling, good handwriting, grammar, and neatness, it is sometimes possible that the teachers might overlook the other logical sequencing. All these four parameters are taken care of, and sometimes if it is not good or not taken care by the students, even a good answer can go unnoticed. Halo effect. When it comes to essay answers, sometimes it so happens that because of the length of the answer, not all teachers go to read the entire concept that is presented. They just sometimes look at the way it is presented, looking at the key points mentioned. And that halo effect can also become a part of your evaluation, because halo effect in a way that when you assume one student to be good at something, you naturally keep on assuming that whatever that the student will write or do will always be right or would always be in the correct form. So this is what an halo effect is, because it makes the teacher feel in a particular way about a student or about a particular process. So it, in a way, injustice to the other students who are trying to improve, because they'll be looked in a certain way throughout their studies. Good verbal ability. Those who have good verbal ability will be in a better position to express. Those who lack it, it will be a bit difficult for them to express what they want to. Mood of the examiner. Again, if the examiner is in a good mood, would get the students would get good marks, because the examiner will read all those points very properly. If it is not, then it might cause problems, because it is a bit subjective, so there is no right or wrong answer. It is the degree of correctness that we look at. So it becomes a bit difficult to be more just when it comes to essay kind of answers. And the first impression, so if you have your first impression right, that is a good handwriting, good presentation, then sometimes the students end up getting good marks, and those who do not have good handwriting in spite of having good content. So these were some of the disadvantages of essay type of a test. Now, how we can improve essay tests? Are there any ways by which we can improve these types of tests? Because the disadvantages are underlying this particular test. So there are certain things that we need to take care of, like while framing questions, give adequate time and thought, because you don't just give questions which come to your mind, or straightforward questions. That question should have something for the child to do or think critically. Questions should be so written that it will elicit the type of behavior teacher wants to measure, so they should be written properly. Establish the value of each part of the question. If you have a double barrel question, then each question should be having that value, and it should contribute to the answer. Do not start essay questions with words like list, who, what, whether. The wording should be clear and unambiguous. There shouldn't be any confusion in the question framing. Expected length of the answer should be mentioned. Ensure that the maximum content is covered in the question. Questions should not be vague, general, or comprehensive. They should be specific, and it should be very clear what the students are expected to answer. Questions should be arranged in order of difficulty. Less difficult to more difficult. We'll continue discussing more about essay test in our next video. Thank you.